Hi, I'm iHanna. In this video, I'm sharing the latest DIY project from my studio, and it's my polka dot oilcloth table that I am sprucing up a bit after I've had this pink and polka dot oilcloth for a couple of years. And as you can see, these stains won't go away even though I scrubbed it down quite hard because it's acrylic paint and some glue stick that just won't go away. And the edges are starting to fray. So this oilcloth is not making me as happy as I used to be when I watched it, and so I'm exchanging it now. To just remove these staples that are quite strong all around the table. The more staples you have around the table, the better it will be during the years when this is on your table. But it's quite difficult to remove them, so be careful. And I'm using a tool when I do my second round under the table where I'm removing all these staples, as you can see here. This is just a tool that helps you get them out without hurting your fingers. Yeah, so here is the light blue polka dot oilcloth that I recently bought, and that is shiny, new, and spotless, except for the polka dots that are spots too, of course. They make me so happy, and I love surrounding myself with polka dots. So that's why I'm going with the same pattern this time, even though it's another color. I'm using a scissor to remove the excess and just roughly cutting around the table when the tablecloth is out, because this is my biggest surface. So it's easiest when it's just laying out flat on the table. And once it's cut to size, you just go around with your staple gun. You put a couple of staples in under the table, and then you walk all the way around and do it on the opposite side so that you can always stretch it and remove all the wrinkles from the surface as best as you can. And just be careful so you don't shoot yourself in the eye or in the roof, because these are quite heavy staples and you can hurt yourself if you're not careful. My best advice is to just hold it under the table so that you get the support you need to push up and staple inside of the table. And if it doesn't go in all the way, you can go back with a hammer and push it into the table so you don't accidentally get caught on it when you sit by the table later. I think by far the corners are the hardest parts to get right. But after a bit of practice and smoothing down the edges, I think this one turned out quite neat, and I'm really happy with my new oilcloth polka dot covered table. I think it's both pretty and neat, and after all this hard work, I think we all deserve to get a cup of coffee. My hands are in cramp and I'm going to have some rest. I hope this project inspired you to do something similar. Here's a quick throwback to how my table usually looks, with all things piling up in one corner, and stickers and papers and stationery and pens and tape, and sometimes my laptop in the middle of everything. This is my sweet creative reality, and I really love it. I just wanted you to see why I need an oilcloth attached to my table. Have a great day!